One of the interesting things to look at from the Aadhar Amendment Act is that the Supreme Court in the case of Puttuswamy versus Union of India had ruled Section 57 of the Aadhar Act as partly unconstitutional insofar as it allowed private companies to, by contract, authenticate data of individuals. However, the amendment bill completely eliminates this Section 57. The question then is that how does it impact the fintech industry? For sure, the fintech industry has suffered after the Aadhar judgment because a lot of the online verification processes that they could actually enter into to authenticate data is not happening. Bank accounts were being opened with a substantial degree of ease, and Paytm KYC verifications were happening really fast. Now, does the Aadhar amendment bill change that? By omitting Section 57, the question is, can private entities still be engaging in this kind of functions? So it creates a new definition, a new concept called an Aadhar ecosystem, which does not prohibit private participants from being a part of that Aadhar ecosystem. And these participants will be governed by the UIDAI, and the UIDAI can give guidelines, regulations. It is an umbrella governing authority for these, which was not the case earlier under the old act. Okay, and there are additional privacy and safety and security standards prescribed under the Aadhar Act, and these can be fleshed out in more detail in the regulations. So it seems that the Aadhar Act has addressed the concerns pointed out by the Supreme Court, created a new way for private entities to enter the space subsequently, and also omitted the controversial Section 57. Now, we have to obviously wait and see till the amendment bill is passed, because until then it will not be effective.